If your MCAT starts at 6:30 a.m., 12:15, or 6 p.m., how do you make sure that you're fully awake and alert for the entire exam? Hey guys, this is Leah from leahforsci.com/MCAT. In this video, I'm going to show you how to shift your timeline so that you're fully awake from that first chem phys question to that last psych soc question. Let's face it, no matter how well you prepare for the MCAT, if you're tired and your brain isn't working, you're going to lose points. And after all the hard work you put in to get to this place, can you afford to lose points just because you're fatigued? I don't think so. So let's fix it. You can find detailed instructions for everything I discussed here by clicking the link below or going to leahforsci.com/MCAT window. Whether you're an early bird or a night owl, your body tends to follow a certain clock, a certain ideal time when you wake up and when you go to sleep. If you try to shift that clock, you find yourself super tired, cranky, and not functioning. But if you're allowed to wake up at that comfortable time, you tend to function better. So let's see if we can take that window and shift it early or shift it late, depending on when you're testing. Let's review the windows first, then talk about the ideal wake up and bedtime. The wake-up time should follow your test time, but also how long you need to get ready. How long does it take you to get out of bed when your alarm goes off? To take a shower? To eat breakfast? Do you like to take a walk or yoga or something similar in the morning? How far are you from the test center? So calculate all of that to figure out how much time you need to build in before your exam. Typically, from when you wake up until you're fully alert, it's about 2 hours to be ready to go. For the end of the exam, you want to make sure that you're functioning at least 2 hours after so that you're not crashing at the end of the exam. Say you're testing at 6 p.m., your exam doesn't end until 11:45. If you're used to going to sleep at midnight, you're going to start crashing during the last section. But if you're very comfortable passing out at 2 a.m., you're still very sharp after 11 p.m. during the entire psych soc section. The 6:30 exam is the hardest because 2 hours before that is 4:30 a.m. But guess what? You have to get yourself used to waking up at 4 to 4:30 so that when you're at the testing center and you're signing in at 6 a.m. and you're starting your exam about 6:30, you're not still waking up, but instead you're fully awake, fully alert, ready to go. So we'll start the window at 4:30 the latest. That gives you a 2 hour buffer. You're testing from 6:30 till about 12:15. Then we want at least 2 hours after, which puts you at 2:15. That means your minimum awake window has to be 4 a.m. till 2:15 p.m. 12:15 is the easiest. If we cut 2 hours off that, you have to wake up at the latest 10:15. Your exam is from 12:15 till 6 p.m. and then the 2 hours after puts you at 8 p.m. That leaves your minimum window from 10:15 till 8 p.m. And I would argue, why not get up at say 9 a.m. so you have time for yoga, a walk, something to wake you up, to get you in the zone, but nothing too strenuous that you burn out before your MCAT. The 6 p.m. exam is challenging, not so much in the wake-up time, but rather in staying awake long enough through the end of the exam. The window starts at 4 p.m. Your exam goes from 6 to 11:45. That means it closes at 1:45 a.m. Now, I'm going to argue you don't want to be going to sleep at 1:45 because typically the closer you are to bedtime, the more fatigued you are, the more tired you are. So try to push it a little bit longer. But that minimum window, 4 p.m., till 1:45 a.m. If you already know when you're testing, write down your window, then make sure you give this video a thumbs up, and let's figure out how to actually be alert during that window. I don't recommend diving into this in one day, trying to force yourself onto a new schedule, because the transition time is going to be so hard, you're likely going to lose a few study days. But you also get there faster, so maybe something to consider. For most people, the best thing to do is shift your schedule by 15 to 30 minutes at a time, depending on how much time you have. If you're not testing for at least 4 weeks or more, don't even worry about this now. Just have it in the back of your mind, make a plan, and then when you get to phase three, start working on this one day at a time. Take 3 weeks to shift your schedule. The fourth week should follow the test day routine from start to finish every single day. And then test day is going to feel like just another day where I focus between these hours and I ace my exam. The strategy I'm about to share follows what I teach in the Wake Up article linked below. We'll start with 9 hours of sleep, where you give yourself 9 hours, but if you only need 8 or 7, you wake up a little bit earlier, that's fine, but don't plan for less, because if you're fatigued, the experiment's not going to work as well. And can you afford to risk it on test day? I don't think so. 6:30 a.m. testers, this is going to be the hardest. Back in the military days, when we had to get up before the sun, it was so depressing, but you do get used to it. Trust me, you get used to it. If you're going to have 9 hours of sleep where you wake up at 4 a.m., you have to go to sleep at 7 p.m. Now it's summer, the sun doesn't even go down before 7 p.m., it's gonna be hard. Make sure you have blackout curtains, an eye cover, earplugs. The world doesn't care that you're trying to sleep early, so you have to tune that out to get into the routine. If you're used to going to sleep at 1 a.m., 7 might be too early. Don't start with 7. Bring your bedtime down slowly. If your exam is more than 4 weeks away and your typical bedtime is 1 a.m., what if you intentionally start getting to bed now at midnight or even 11 p.m.? Now, you're probably not going to fall asleep at 11 p.m. for quite a few days because you're so used to going to sleep 2 hours later. That's okay. Get ready for bed, get into bed, and then read, not your phone, not a Kindle, read a physical book until you tire out enough to go to sleep. And if you wind up reading from 11 p.m. till 1 a.m., that's fine. You're still resting more than if you were wide awake. And every day, you're going to find yourself tiring a little earlier and a little earlier until guess what? 11 p.m., you're feeling tired enough, you go to sleep. Now, as you get to phase three, 11 p.m. becomes 10:45, 10:30, all the way down till 7. At the same time, your alarm is going to change. Say you're used to waking up at 9, set it to 8:30, set it to 8, and slowly, slowly work your way down till 4 a.m. If you have a 12:15 exam, that's the easiest. You can wake up around 9 or 10 a.m., depending on what you want to do in the morning. I recommend trying to get in a long walk or some yoga, something that forces you to de-stress, to calm down, to relax, gives you enough time to get ready and take your exam. I don't recommend getting up too early. Don't be that super motivated morning person who wakes up at 7 a.m. and now you have hours to kill before your exam, hours where you're unproductive. Maybe you're trying to cram, which you know you shouldn't do, but what else are you going to do? Or you just freak yourself out. Don't do any of that. Get into a very comfortable routine where you go to sleep at midnight, you wake up about 9 a.m., and then you don't have enough time to stress, just enough time to calmly get ready. And if you're not used to passing out at 12, say you go to sleep at 2 or 3 regularly, do the same thing that we discussed before by slowly, slowly bringing your bedtime down so that you are passing out by midnight and able to get that full night's sleep. Finally, we have the 6 p.m. exam. If your exam is at 6 p.m. and you wake up sometime in the morning, you have an entire day before your exam, an entire day of activity, of stress, of mental stimulation, everything that is going to take your potentially fresh brain in the morning, scramble it, and then you're trying to focus for 5 hours and 45 minutes. I don't recommend that. If you're testing at 6 p.m., I challenge you, become a night owl, become one of those people who does not sleep until very, very late, and try to go to sleep anywhere from 3 to even 5 a.m., just maybe go to sleep before the sun comes up so you don't completely mess with your brain. Every day, ask yourself, what can I do to stay up a little bit later today, a little bit later today? And if you can get into the habit where you're going to sleep at 5 a.m., Then don't even set an alarm, just see what time you naturally wake up. If you can get to a point where you're waking up at 2 or 3 p.m., guess what? You're not a bum. This is actually very important. You have just enough time for your morning routine, obviously in the afternoon, maybe a light workout, yoga, or walking, and then showing up to the exam refreshed, ready to go, but also ready to focus all the way till midnight without crashing at the end of your exam. What do you think? If you have one of these crazy test start times, do you see yourself being able to implement something like this so that you can be fully awake, fully alert for the entire duration of the exam? If yes, first, give this video a thumbs up, then let me know in the comments below what other concerns you have about this new pandemic MCAT. And then visit the link below or go to my website, leahforsci.com/pandemicMCAT. All one word, that's leahforsci.com/pandemicMCAT.